Life's too short to drive boring cars.
So the question is often asked, why do new car buyers buy BMWs? After all, there's a reputation that they're unreliable, that their parts and service cost a lot of money. So why would people buy BMWs when you can buy a car like a Lexus that has endless amounts of dependability built into it? The truth of the matter is there's five reasons, and I'm going to share with you why people would actually buy them. I personally have owned numerous BMWs in my life, and even though there are some concerns, the positives far outweigh the negatives. So let's get into it now. So the first reason people buy BMWs as a new vehicle is because their performance, their drivetrains, and their overall handling and braking performance. Here, I'll give you some examples. Here we have the new M8. Beautiful car all the way around. Look at the style of that, but we're talking about performance. We're talking about braking performance. Look at the size of those brakes. They're bigger than a whole Lexus rim all the way around. Those calipers are just massive. The aerodynamics of these cars also helps with performance at high speeds. Look at the exhaust tips. They're not just fake tips. That's because it's a finely tuned engine tucked away under the hood of these cars. This here is a 4.4 liter twin turbo V8, shared also from the F90 M5. You can get it in the M8 as well, like the new X5 competition. You can get that engine that makes 620 horsepower. That's insanity. This puts down 0 to 60 in quarter mile times as quick as a Lamborghini Huracan or an Audi R8. These things are phenomenally quick. 0 to 60 times, you're down in that 2.9 second range. Or how about the engine tucked away in this car? This is the new 3 Series, and you can tell this one carries the B58, which is the single turbo engine, because of this grille. It has this little crosshatch grille. Just by looking at that, you can tell it's a 40 series. So you've got M badging there. And there you go, you've got the M340i. That six-cylinder engine is available in almost every model. You can get that same six-cylinder engine as well in a 2 series. Right here we have an M240i as well. You can get that six-cylinder turbo there. You can also get it in the X3 right there, M40i. You can get that twin-scroll single-turbo engine in many of the models. X3s, X4s, X5s. You can get it in, as I say, 2, 3, 4 series cars. You can even get it in the convertibles right there. But they do come in different states of tune, anywhere from just over 300 horsepower up to about 385. And did you know that that engine is so desirable that Toyota even reached out to BMW, and it's the same engine that they use in the new Toyota Supra. This year, by the way, it gets the full state of tune that the BMWs are putting out. BMW has always made engines that perform like a rock star. They've also made cars that handle like they're on rails and usually brakes to match. The cars are always very well balanced. Did you forget that little race series called Formula One? Well, they're very successful there as well. And we won't even talk about their Sport Touring series and a lot of other race series that BMW gets involved with. There's no question they're high-end motorsports, and because of that, their level of performance in many of their models is well sought after by buyers across the board. We can't forget about these beautiful cars as well, right here. This is the outgoing M4 model. Absolutely stunning in this color. Now, these carry the S55 engine, which was the sport-tuned version of the N55, but this one's twin turbo. Other than carbon fouling and the crank hub issue that happens on a very small percentage of these cars, this was truly a dynamic beast. Competitor, strong competitor against the Porsche 911. These cars are spectacular. But what's that all about? Uh-oh, we've got the tow hook out of there, so something must have happened. We also don't want to forget about the E60 M5, which essentially has the F1-inspired V10 engine that makes over 500 horsepower. How about that Gordon Murray inspiration with the McLaren F1? Yes, that beautiful, glorious V12 naturally aspirated engine making over 600 horsepower came provided complements of BMW. So there's no question in my mind, BMW really does own the performance aspect. They got the braking, the handling, the dynamics. They've got performance in a straight line and everything in between. That's why people do seek these cars out, particularly the enthusiasts. So the second reason why these cars are bought by new car buyers is because of style. It doesn't take very long to find cars that look very stylish. You can get 8 series cars, for example. They come in a coupe, or you can get them in a convertible. You get one style of wheel. You can get another style of rim, and they come in the M series, like the M8 right here. All kinds of different styling aspects to these cars. You've got very aggressive vents everywhere on these vehicles, from the front grille that looks next level to these aggressive vents in the front. These really cool mirrors that don't connect right up at the top. Additional vents on the sides. How about those great little wings that you find on the back of these cars? Very stylish rear splitters and quad exhaust on some of the cars. Again, look at the M4, chock full of interesting designs. Look at that aggressive front spoiler on there, or the bulging hood in the center. Very, very aggressive. Again, you've got that style of mirror right there, same as that last car. Bit of a ducktail rear trunk lid. And again, quad exhaust system. How about vents like this? I mean, they even have roadsters still in a day where that seems to be passe. How about the brand new 4 Series? Very controversial, but nonetheless, they are reaching to try different things in terms of styling. Now, you still have that great sloping rear quarter. Yes, very, very interesting nonetheless. And as well, you don't have to spend $100,000 to get the design. Even a lower end 2 Series car has some of the same design themes. You've got the interesting vents in the front as well, just an overall design element. It's dialed down, of course, for costs, but it still has a lot of the same themes. It's got interesting wheels, you get dual exhaust, you got LED taillights matching up with LED headlights. BMW also carries it through with their SUVs, and they add styling even to the lower end SUVs like ZX4s, X3s, as well as their i3s to get the treatments. So whether you're looking for a fire-breathing dragon in an M car, or you're looking for something more pedestrian in a 3 or 4 series car, you will still find a certain amount of style and you will get noticed nonetheless. So the next reason why people care about buying a BMW new is because the brand. Basically, a lot of times people nowadays care a lot more about reputation, about status, and it becomes a status symbol. People buy them because saying, I drive a BMW, it states something, like I've made it. So a lot of times people feel that they want to have that brand name. Same thing goes with driving a Benz or maybe an Audi, you know, as opposed to maybe driving a mainstream brand. You know, they buy a BMW because it states something. What it states? Well, unfortunately, there's different reputations. Some people say it states that I'm a bit of a jerk, but sometimes it just means that, you know what, that they're financially well off and that they've finally done something right to be able to buy their new dream car. So it is about the branding in a lot of cases. So the next reason why people sometimes buy BMW brand has to do with the way they're put together. Now, as you look here, we have an older generation. This is an E46 M3. It's certainly got some miles on it, you can tell. It's driven hard, but you know what? It's still well put together. And I know from experience that these cars still are tight. This car is numerous years old, but it still feels very tight. As a matter of fact, it's probably tighter than a 2-year-old Toyota. And then we have a car like this, slightly newer, but still an older generation BMW. Also, guaranteed, they feel well put together. These older BMWs feel screwed together and glued together. They're tight, door handles feel good in the hands, doors feel tight when you shut them, trunk lids generally don't rattle. And even the brand new generation stuff. I've driven, test driven, virtually every model under the sun of BMW, and I can honestly attest, when you get in behind the wheel of, say, a Benz and an Audi, they feel a little bit different. As a matter of fact, recently my wife bought a C300 Coupe from Mercedes. Sure, it's lower end, but this would be its direct competitor, would be a 3 Series BMW, and all day long, this car feels tighter, tauter, more screwed together, more glued together, and it just overall feels like a better put together car. BMWs are very stiff, rigid, and they often feel like they're carved out of a chunk of granite because they feel so well put together. Now, we're not talking about reliability or any of the concerns with specific technical issues, but in terms of its chassis and the way doors close and sunroofs open and operate and noises while you're banging down the road hitting uneven pavement, BMWs are some of the tightest cars available on the road, and not only when they're new. They hold up that way for 10, 15, sometimes 20 years. And I guarantee you that can't be said for a lot of other brands. So yet another reason why BMWs are sought after by new car buyers, because they're always very innovative and there's lots of great new technology. Such as this, we have the laser lights. This is the laser LED by BMW. This is their new LED system, their upgrade. Now, it's not just a gimmick. It's not about calling it a laser so you're gonna zap and blow up that guy in traffic when he gets in your way, shoot a laser and he's gone. No, it's more than that. It's much more than that. And it's also not about these pieces of blue plastic that are embedded in there. What it is, many LED headlights by many manufacturers are good for about 300 or 400 meters down the road. But this style here does a little bit more than that. It's actually good up to almost 600 meters. And what it is they send three beams through that blue piece of phosphorus material, comes together in one very condensed, strong white LED light that shoots out almost 600 meters. So the technology is there all about bright and reaching out into the depths of the darkness when you're driving through that dark canyon road. Another piece of technology BMW more or less initiated. Well, you've heard of the iDrive system. Nothing new there. It's been through many, many generations. But do you realize they were literally one of the very first on the block coming up with that technology where you can interface with basically a mouse controller or a roller controller there, and you can access all your different elements and make changes and set point updates within your actual computer. You can engage more than just pressing buttons. That's right, BMW is way ahead of the game. There's some other things, for example, the general construction of these vehicles today. There's no question now with safety add-ons. We have hybrid technologies, batteries are heavy, extra performance, extra luxury, it all adds weight. How is it that BMW is able to offset some of that weight? Well, it's some of the construction techniques. For example, they use a lot of aluminum now. For example, panels like this are aluminum. They've got lots of aluminum on this body structure. They've got aluminum in the subframe. And as well, in some cases, they're using carbon fiber. Sometimes there's carbon fiber on the wheels. Sometimes there's carbon fiber here. Sometimes there's carbon fiber in the dash. And at the very least, and now what sometimes BMW is using, particularly in some of the iCars, the i3 and the i8, is injection molding. Now that is essentially reused, recycled plastic combined with a bunch of other elements, creates a very strong, interesting design, and it's ultra lightweight, so it sheds weight versus a standard conventional plastic dashboard. They use this other technology to reduce weight. Now, did you realize as well, the new X5 is actually a reduced coefficient of drag? That's right, a 0.31 coefficient, because it's not just air hitting the front and then going off to the sides. They actually funnel air through the vents, and then it comes around the wheels and it gets redirected, and as you can see output there. So they're moving air through the vehicle more effectively versus just ramming it and then just slowing a vehicle down. And that really helps with efficiency for performance and economy, which is going to be very important. As they reduce the engine sizes, they need to reduce the coefficient of drag so the vehicle slides through the air a lot easier. These are the things that BMW are constantly looking at for technology. We won't even talk about turbos, twin scroll, and the efficiency there. Lots of their turbocharging adds huge amounts of power, and as well, just they're able to reduce engine size and yield a much bigger output. As they did, for example, when they went with the M5 and they went with the twin turbo V8 versus the outgoing M5, they reduced carbon emissions and increased the output overall. Did you realize as well, BMW is now integrating systems that learn your driving behavior? They adopt different throttle inputs, they adopt different shift changes within the transmission, all based on the learnings it does based on your driving style, and it makes it more, much more seamless. And with all of that said, you're probably wondering, is the new Lexus IS a better driving car than the new BMW 3 Series? Check it out right there. I'm going to answer all those questions for you. Hope to see you guys real soon. Catch you then. Bye-bye.